Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Industrialist Rahul Bajaj on Saturday said something that shook up the entire establishment. Speaking at an event where Home Minister Amit Shah was present along with senior cabinet ministers, Mr. Bajaj said that while the government was doing a good job, there was very little faith among India Inc. that any criticism would be received positively. Now, this of course was responded to by Home Minister Amit Shah, and we've also seen a chain of reactions, including by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. But this really opens itself up to a larger debate. It opens itself up to a larger conversation at a time when the economy is witnessing unprecedented slowdown. Is greater conversation, is in fact greater honest conversation between India Inc. and the government needed? And if it takes place already, what kind of channels does it go through? That's what we're going to look at in Government Matters today. Ramya Nair is with me today. She covers economy for The Print, and you're by now very familiar with her. Ramya, to begin with, this is something that really everybody talks about, perhaps behind closed doors and in private circles. Did it come as a surprise to the entire sector, to the entire corporate sector, that Mr. Bajaj actually said it out loud at an event where there were senior ministers present?
So Rahul Bajaj has had a history of, you know, openly voicing his disagreements. Right. So it may have not, come as a surprise for fellow industrialists, because he's known to be outspoken. But and he seems to have expressed views of most of the corporates there present in that room. So I don't think it's come as a surprise, but it possibly caught the government ministers who were on the stage by surprise. That included, you know, Commerce Minister Piyush Goyal and Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, along with Home Minister Amit Shah. Yeah.
Now, there have been a range of reactions since then. So let's just recap a little bit of those for our viewers before we go any further. So Mr. Amit Shah said something. Ms. Nirmala Sitharaman has said something. Yeah.
So on the stage, when, you know, Mr. Bajaj talked about it, Amit Shah was pretty receptive about what Mr. Bajaj said, and he said that there's no need to for anyone to fear, and they can openly express their views to the government. But however, the reactions that have followed, you know, don't seem to be in spirit of that that line that the Home Minister took. So we had Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman tweeting on how, you know, this kind of a open airing of this criticism could actually hurt national interest. So is the government again telling the companies, corporates, that no, you cannot go and express your concerns about the state of the economy or about tax terrorism or something as common as, you know, Sadhvi Pragya's remark that, you know, you cannot be openly expressing your criticism about some of the government's decisions.
In fact, Mr. Hardeep Puri, who's also minister, has also criticized Mr. Rahul Bajaj for his statement. So clearly, in a way, these ministers seem to be proving Mr. Bajaj right. Their criticism will not be received very positively. But Ramya, it obviously comes in the context of an economic slowdown. Can you give us some parameters? We know the latest GDP figures came out, which were anything but positive, but some parameters which may have prompted Mr. Bajaj to say this.
So, one is his on the, tax terrorism part. You know, there has been a lot of concerns among companies that the income tax department is aggressively going after companies. We had the instance of the alleged suicide of Vijay Siddhartha, the founder of Cafe Coffee Day, wherein he has indicted the tax officials. So that seems to be a concern. Even you had someone like a Mohandas Pai, you know, who's a known supporter of the government. He has expressed concerns over this whole, you know, the use of the tax department machinery. So that's one aspect. Then other aspect is obviously the slowdown in investment, the slowdown in consumption, the fact that the economy is slowing down. So, you know, the so-called animal spirits among, or the entrepreneurial spirits of the companies seems to be, you know, at an all-time low. Companies are not investing. This can be even seen by some indicators that have come along with the GDP data, you know, a measure like a gross fixed capital formation that basically shows the investment demand in the economy that has grown at only 1%. So, you know, these are those indications that yes, companies are not investing. They don't have faith that there will be demand in the future and, you know, that they will be earning in the future. So because of that, they have stopped their investments at present. So obviously there is a need to revive sentiment among companies and, you know, in the economy as a whole.
Right. Now, Ramya, what I want to talk about today is how, you know, as you mentioned, in this backdrop, a greater conversation between India Inc. and the Modi government is perhaps needed. So let's first talk about whether that's happening at all and what are the channels through which these conversations, if at all they happen.
See, for the first, you know, the government needs to first acknowledge that yes, there is a problem.
Right.
The companies are feeling that there is no formal mechanism through which, formal and open mechanism through which they can share their concerns with the government. So first, there has to be an acknowledgement before you set up a formal process, you know, a consultative process. So, you know, the response so far has been, you know, that, oh, we have been doing it, you know. So the finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman's office actually tweeted that, you know, the minister has been meeting with many companies and industrial bodies, and they actually listed out around 23 meetings that she has had since August to, you know, justify the point that no, the government or the finance minister at least is, you know, conducting consultations. But, you know, the government has to acknowledge that probably the companies feel that this is not enough.
Right.
Probably nothing, you know, the government has not been able to address their concerns in terms of, you know, something like as simple as tax terrorism, right? Because these companies have been pointing out from a long time that the tax department has been very aggressive in its tax demands. But on the other hand, the government has not really done anything to reduce the tax targets of the taxmen. Because taxmen, you know, become aggressive because they have to meet their targets.
Right.
At a time when the economy is slowing down, there is no way that the government is able to, will be able to meet its tax collection targets. So there has to be a message to the taxmen
that, that it's okay to not meet targets.
It's okay to not meet targets. But so far, you know, those two kind of statements have not come in. So, you know, there is this, the government is probably not acting or doing enough to address the concerns of the companies.
Right. Now, you know, there is something, as you said, there are consultations that are happening, but it's one thing to have conversations and it's one thing to have honest conversations. And perhaps it, that's what Mr. Bajaj meant, that, you know, even though there might be interactions, there isn't enough honest criticism that is coming forth from the corporate sector. But you do interact with many people from the corporate sector. Off the record, in private, what are the, besides tax terrorism, what are the big concerns that they have?
At present, the main concern that they have is, you know, if we make investments, you know, will the investments lead to future earnings? You know, because economy is slowing down. There is no consumption demand. So, you know, what they are producing, will there be a market for those goods? So that seems to be like the prominent concern besides the whole taxation aspect of it.
Now, Mr. Bajaj also spoke about Pragya Singh Thakur, who is a BJP MP from Bhopal, her remarks in parliament about Nathuram Godse, etc. And this is something that not enough from the corporate sector really talk about. I mean, even if they voice something, it's to do with the economy and not really with the changed politics of the country or social issues. But within the sector, again, as I said, privately, off the record, are there concerns about issues like these?
You know, so this has like kind of resonated with the many corporates, you know. So the first corporate who openly criticized this or probably voiced his concerns was Anand Mahindra, the chairman of the Mahindra Group. You know, at the time during the campaign, the election campaign, when, you know, she first made her remarks about Nathuram Godse. At that point, he had actually flagged this, you know, that he had pointed out on how, you know, this kind of a remark could have been made. So he was probably one of the first people in the corporate sector to have voiced their concerns. And now obviously Rahul Bajaj. But, you know, it comes down to the fact that eventually Mahatma Gandhi is the father of our nation. And how can the ruling party kind of overlook the repeated statements by a Lok Sabha MP who belongs to their party. So.
Right. Now, going forward, Ramya, do you see, I mean, I know the statements that have come, at least from the finance minister, seem fairly defensive. They don't seem particularly, as you said, not in the spirit of what Mr. Amit Shah said at the event where he said that don't be afraid, we are happy to listen to you. But going forward, do you see any mechanism being set up for better interaction, better coordination between the corporate sector and the government?
It remains to be seen, you know, if the government does acknowledge that yes, that is a problem and they, you know, they begin such a process. So, you know, the pre-budget consultations are now going to start. So, the government is going to meet agriculturalists, trade unions, they're going to meet industrialists, they're going to meet economists. So, you know, if the government thinks that that is a part of a formal consultative process, then, you know, they may not really like set up again a mechanism because they'll be like, you know, we are meeting, we are already doing the consultative process. We're going to meet industries and we're going to meet economists, you know, to get their views on what should, what is expected in the budget. And we're going to even meet bankers. So, you know, we'll get a more, we'll get a 360-degree perspective of what is happening. So they may not, they may choose not to, you know, initiate a formal consultative process. But it remains to be seen, you know, the spirit in which the government has taken these suggestions.
Right.
They can always set up such a process, but do they want to, you know, that's the question. Yeah.
Well, Mr. Rahul Bajaj, really, in a way, with his statement, reflecting the trust deficit between the corporate sector, between India Inc. and the Modi government, and the need to bridge that gap with some kind of a consultative process, with some kind of honest conversation between both sides. Ramya Nair, thank you so much for joining us today. Thank you for watching Government Matters. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel.